In episode 1 of Flavors of Romania, we will be exploring Oltenia, once known as Wallachia Minor, and one of the least promoted regions in the country. Starting in the east, we will discover an area rich in spiritual history, where you can find ancient wooden churches and painted murals. We will also be dropping in at the town of Hărezu, famed for its ceramic art.
Să zic în jur de vreo 40 de persoane, de olari, care lucrează această ceramică de Hărezu. Sperăm să se perpetueze în continuare acest meșteșug.
Further off the beaten track, I will be riding out to a remote village where the youngest inhabitant is in their 70s.
Satul ăsta e de mult, mamă, aici. Are 500 de ani. Mi-a spus mie bunicu, când a venit aici, a venit trei persoane, trei familii.
Three families.
Așa. Și satul ăsta așa s-a mulțit.
I will be treading in the footsteps of the sculptor Brancus, although not quite so far.
He went by foot to Paris.
He walked all the way
to Paris. Yes, he literally walked.
From here?
Yes. It took him a year. He stopped
a few... Yeah, would
you? Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
As well as viewing his legacy in nearby Târgu. I will also be meeting up with friend and maestro Bogdan Simeon to get a unique insight into Lotar society, a group of people who have been custodians of some of Romania's oldest songs. We will be seeing an example of how the next generation are promoting tourism in some of Oltenia's most beautiful landscapes. Plus, I will be trying to resist the forces of evil as I stop to examine the famous Devil's Bridge. Nearby, in the village of Bratilov, I'll be looking for a Romanian recipe that does not require the addition of corn.
Yeah, this might not work.
Mama, nu puneți porc?
Nu, numai cu brânză. Numai cu brânză și cu ouă. Dacă am 72 de ani și numai cu din asta am crescut.
We will be dipping into kayaking culture on the Cherna River. I'll be finding out about the rise and fall of Rome from a unique perspective on the banks of the River Danube.
Încă nu am determinat câți oameni intrau în tribune, cam în jur de 5.000, așa, după unele aproximații.
Would there have been a stone floor at the bottom here? Or...
No. Era doar nisip și pietriș pentru a ascunde cât mai bine sângele gladiatorilor.
Wow, to cover up the blood of the gladiators.
And if that's not enough, we'll be getting an insight into carpet making from a woman who has devoted her life to preserving this highly skilled and cultural craft. All this and much more in episode 1 of Flavors of Romania.
Mulțumesc. Hai la turte.